Mr. Rutger van Zuidam, we're talking about the hackathon this year, the hackathon program this year, and I hear that you have you start with a technical deep dive on February the 1st. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about how the hackathon is structured today, and also what's new. I mean, first I see that on the website that the whole organization is now called Odyssey. Is that the whole hackathon and all around it? Is that the new name?
Yeah, Odyssey.org is the name of the innovation program, which runs the whole year. And the hackathon is its highlight. Yeah. And the tech deep dive we have on February the 4th is one of the highlights too, because we use these events in preparation of the hackathon, and we have an epic program, and it's free.
Yeah, and it's free. Yeah, well, a lot of times we've seen that. How many times have you organized the hackathon now?
This is the third season. This is the third edition.
Okay, and I saw that you have even more. You have even more partners and even more room for more teams. So, what is the scope of the program there this year?
Well, it's really about finding ways to co-create open digital public infrastructure. There are 20 challenges, and five teams can enter the competition per challenge. So we have 100 teams this year. The prize money is a total of 200,000 euros in cash rewards. And we have a really nice new companies like Nutreco, KLM, but also companies that have been with us from the beginning, like Vattenfall. Also, Enexis is there, the energy grid operator of the Netherlands. But also, of course, from the government, the Ministry of the Interior, but also Justice and Safety, Ministry of Finance. So, together with the partnership we have with the Authority for Financial Market and the Dutch Central Bank, we have a wide range of partners that can help the teams make something that is really useful in our society. Yeah. And that will be actually available for adoption. I think that's the most important thing, to build something that can actually be adopted by everyone.
Yeah. Okay. So let's talk about that. I mean, the first year was very exciting, and there were a lot of teams, and yeah. and the solutions which were there, they were really nice trials. Then you had the second one. Let's talk a little bit about the results which came out of that, and which solutions are really going on, and then we'll talk about the goal of the third one. And then we're going to talk about the tech deep dive, which is February 4th in Den Bosch, and which I'm planning to be there too. So if we look at the second hackathon and the solutions and the winners of that, how many of those solutions are still alive now after half a year, and our teams which are continuing? Because, of course, we're very curious. We want to make this new operating system for the planet. You have very modest goals. But where are these solutions, and how are they being implemented?
Well, we're keeping track of about 20 teams that are still developing these ideas further, and one team is going faster than the other, of course. And I think for example, the team of Crya, which has won the machine-to-machine economy track, they've made Grex.ai. They started out with autonomous swarm robotics with drones. So they taught 9 drones how to recognize each other and pick tasks and to act autonomously. Yep. They're now currently further developing that with MIT. And so there are all kinds of these examples where teams are really making progress. A lot of teams got new clients. Some of the teams even got funded. So we're really happy to see them making progress. Of course, most of the stuff is not in production yet, but these things are pretty hard.
First, see who is alive, and then secondly, which of these big companies which gave all these challenges, are there also examples of companies which have said, hey, this is an interesting identity, or this isn't a nice financial application which they're just developing for their own business?
Yeah, I think what sets this year apart is that the companies say, we want to work with the teams that develop something of which we can be part of, but we don't want to own it. So the whole thing about this open digital public infrastructure, these new second layer protocols, is the funny thing is that they're part of the digital commons. And that means nobody owns them. Everybody can build on top of them and everybody can use them. And hey, oh yeah, we know that already from the great internet protocols and from Bitcoin too. So this is really the new thing this year, is that everybody really understands this. And I think last year we've seen a lot of projects fail because they didn't understand this. And that's why I'm very excited. For example, I mean, the ministries of the Netherlands, they are looking for a protocol for digital consent. Well, that's really, really useful, right? On the other hand, KLM is looking for a way to safely communicate biometrical data when traveling the world. So there's a lot of difference between the challenges. Yeah. I mean, Willy Smits, he's going to talk at the Tech Deep Dive as well. He's literally building rainforests, and we're also looking for a digital public infrastructure to support that specific regeneration of ecosystems that support endangered species. So you see a wide range of challenges this year. Yeah. In fossil-free future with Vattenfall, and of course the Nature 2.0 track with Enexis.
Yeah, I see. Rethink retirement, inclusive banking, scaling ecosystems, but also something very practical like the future of cargo insurance.
Yeah, so, that's really exciting.
These companies are not working on practical solutions for themselves, but more bigger issues which are useful for their whole industry.
Yeah, they understand that if you unlock such a protocol, is that you enable the market to be built on top of that and to make progress as a whole. And so you lower the network costs of the complete market.
Yeah, okay, so that's nice. They're still very more in a liberal mindset. They want to develop the market themselves. They're not really practically working on things for themselves. So it's really nice that they're, after 3 years, that they're still supporting that. You have a program. You have a number of events during the year, and we saw that in the House of Parliament. You had your sessions. You had your session there. What's happening on February the 4th?
Yeah, we have every year the Tech Deep Dive, and that's where we really lift the hood of all the blockchain and AI technologies, and really dive deep into the technical part of it. So no fluffy marketing talks, but really the core developers that are talking. So we have Georges Prevost, who is a core developer of Bitcoin, and he's going to talk about building on Bitcoin. What can you build on Bitcoin other than wallets and exchanges and stuff like that? We have Jutta Steiner from Parity, who was also in the Ethereum core team, who's going to address the state of Ethereum. And we have Tran McCunney, who is talking about AI for the commons. And it's basically about creating public intelligence networks. And Ocean Protocol, I think it's one of the most beautiful European technology projects at the moment, which completely has rethought the way we can handle and exchange our own data and stay safe and make it more liquid. Okay. So that's very exciting. And we have some of the winners of the hackathons we did. So in June, we also did a hackathon with the EU, with the European Commission and the EU Intellectual Property Office in Alicante. And the winners from that EU blockathon, we were able to support, and they are coming to tell about their digital twin solution. They've built it on Bitcoin.
Is that already a Lightning solution, or is that just basically using the core of the Bitcoin protocol to have a digital? Yes. So I can take something off my phone, and I have a digital twin, and I can keep track of the ownership of this thing by having my digital twin.
Yeah.
And I can do that on the blockchain, on the just the original blockchain of Bitcoin. So it's not a Lightning solution.
It's not Lightning yet, but I think there's a lot of potential there, and it works. And they understand it very, very well. So I'm very excited that they will speak at the deep dive. Yeah. We also have Erik Laan, who is going to talk about blockchain and satellites. So how can satellites communicate with second layer blockchain based protocols. So that's also very exciting. He installed his Blockstream satellite. He's going to talk about that, but there's a lot more there. And of course, Willy Smits, we're flying him in from all the way from Borneo, and he's literally programming nature. He is programming real ecosystems, and he's one of the challenges at the hackathon, and we can learn so much from him in the way he uses an engineering approach to fixing nature and aligning interests of the local communities, endangered species, and the whole rainforest. So that's very exciting too.
Okay. So it's for people who are not interested in marketing. You have to be interested in the technical aspects of the different protocols and about Ethereum and about the newest thing on blockchain, on the Bitcoin blockchain. Ocean Protocol is there. And then a bunch of applications. For who are you looking for? Who should come to the Tech Deep Dive? You say it's for free. Everybody can just go there to odyssey.org and sign up. Okay. But for who do you want there?
Yeah, well, it's especially focused at developers and software engineers, computer scientists, but also technically savvy entrepreneurs, policymakers, lawyers. Last year we had a couple of lawyers, and it was a lot of fun when the lawyers connect with the software developers, because hey, guess what, if you build a software for complete ecosystems, then the law has something to do with that. So basically every tech savvy interested to really build, if you're a criticaster and you want to really learn about what the heck is going on the Bitcoin, on Ethereum, of course, it's a perfect place to really dive deeper into the technology, not just the promise, not the promises, but really where is the technology right now.
Yeah, but you don't have to be having a team which is participating. You can be
interested. No. This is just a preparatory event to learn and to connect. And what also is interesting, you can connect with all the partners, with all the challenge holders, like Nutreco and KLM and the ministries and Vattenfall and Enexis and all these companies, TVM, the cargo insurance. They are there with an expo. And they're there to connect with the potential teams who will register for the hackathon. Okay. So it's a really good way to learn about why they are doing this and what they are looking for.
Okay, wonderful. Well, we need a good public digital infrastructure in the crypto world, because I mean it takes forever before all these blockchains are good enough to make practical solutions, because before they're fast enough, before they're cheap enough, before they're stable enough, before the tools work. I mean, we've been in this business now for 8 years or something like that. I mean, I feel like an extremely old person. In the meantime, you got kids, you got married, you have you started a bunch of companies and that kind of stuff. And we're still waiting for that. We had, of course, in general, the purpose of money. We had the first things with smart contracts. We had all kinds of startups which started their own coin. We really want to have good solutions. So I'm really appreciating that you get those challenges from real companies, that they want to back it up with money and effort, and that you do all this deep dive. So I'll be there on February the 4th, and I hope that everybody who's interested into come up with real-time solutions and practical solutions, and not only criticize or not only be enthusiastic, but start building on it. So
that's the most important
Bos, thing. Eh? It's in Den Bosch, the 4th. Where is it?
Yeah, it's at the Euronymous Academy for Data Science. The location will be distributed to everyone who registered. But it's a really cool location. It's a university for data sciences. It's pretty new, but it's very forward moving. And I'm very excited that they were ready and enthusiastic to host this really cool community event.
Yeah, how many people fit in the room there?
Over 500.
Okay. All right. It looks very cool. So I'll see you there. Enjoy the skiing in Switzerland. Is there enough snow?
Yeah. As you can see, Vince, there's there's quite a lot of snow, not too much, just perfect.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I'll see you in Den Bosch.
Thank you so much.
In
Den Bosch. Bye bye, Vincent.
Bye.